Welcome to Advanced Data Entry in ICMS. This course will teach you methods to speed up the data entry process in the Interior Collection Management System using Copy This Record, Defaults and Carryover fields, and the Mass Update features Modify All, Global Search and Replace, and Quick Entry. Prerequisites for this lesson are the lessons for Basic Navigation, Basic Data Entry, and Queries, which explains how to activate a tag or filter and how to select multiple records in the list pane. All of the information we'll cover in this course is also available in several other places. Chapter 6 of the ICMS User Manual covers data entry and advanced editing. All DOI units using ICMS should already have a copy of the manual. It is also available in PDF format on the Rediscovery FTP site at ftp://ftp.rediscov.com/ICMS and on the DOI Museum Program website at www.doi.gov/museum/ICMS. We strongly recommend you refer to the user manual as you use ICMS. Also, the system help describes all of the program's functions. System help is available from anywhere in ICMS from the help menu or by pressing F1. It includes chapters on data entry and mass updating tools. The data entry chapter explains how to copy records and use defaults and carryover fields. The mass updating tools section describes modify all, global search and replace, and quick entry. The index tab in system help is especially useful. If you cannot remember what chapter contains the information you need, click on the Index tab and enter the subject, for example, Modify All. Now we'll learn to use these advanced data entry functions. These functions work the same in any module of ICMS. We'll use the Cultural Resources Catalog Records for this lesson. The Edit menu includes all of these advanced data entry functions. Some of these functions are available only when a tag or filter is active, or when multiple records are selected in the list pane. The Queries lesson explains tags, filters, and selecting records in the list pane. Note that Copy This Record and Defaults and Carryover fields are accessible to users with at least data entry rights. Modify All Records, Global Search and Replace, and Quick Entry are accessible to administrator users and users with data entry rights plus specific rights for Modify All, which also includes Global Search and Replace, and Quick Entry. Use Copy This Record to add a record that is the same or similar to an existing record. First, locate a record similar to the one you need to add. The record you want to copy must be the selected record. It will be highlighted in the list pane and will show in the record pane. Choose Copy This Record from the Edit menu or click the Copy button. A new window opens for the new record you're creating. It shows the data from the source record you are copying. Note the status bar at the bottom indicates copy mode. You must enter a new catalog number to save the record. Then edit any other fields as needed to match the object you are cataloging. For example, if the object is from a different accession, enter the correct accession number. If the object is stored in a different location, enter the correct location. When finished, click Save and Close to save the record. Remember to complete the Track Changes fields as you normally do when saving a new record. The new record is saved. Use defaults and carryover fields to define values or data that will automatically fill in when you add a new record. Each user may save their own default values and activate them for use when adding new records. From the Edit menu, choose defaults and carryover fields, then choose Create New Defaults. On the Defaults Properties tab, enter a name and optional description for the default set. On the Default Data tab, fill in the fields as you want them to be filled in when you add a new record. For example, if you are cataloging a large group of sherds from a single accession, you could fill in the classification and object fields. And you could fill in the root of the catalog number so that you only have to enter the unique number for each new record. And you could fill in the accession number that all of the records are part of. And you could fill in the location, object status, and item count if they are the same for all the records you're cataloging. Alternatively, click the checkbox next to the fields that you want to carry over from the current record when you add a new record. For example, carry over the catalog number field. When you add a record, the new record will carry over the catalog number from the previous record, so you'll know the last number used and can enter the next number in the sequence. Click Save and Close to save this default set to use later, or click Save and Activate to save and activate the default set to start adding new records. We'll click Save and Activate so we can see these defaults in use. Note that the status bar indicates we're using those defaults. With defaults active, add a new record. The status bar indicates add mode. Note all the fields already filled in with the default data we defined. The catalog number field carried over the number from the record we were viewing, and we can edit it to use the next number in the sequence. With defaults active, every time you add a new record, your default values will already be filled in. Exiting the program will deactivate your default set, but you won't lose what you set up. To reactivate defaults, use the Edit menu, Defaults and Carryover fields, Activate Defaults option. Select your default set and click Activate. Use Modify All Records to update a group of records with the same data. You can make updates in one or more fields at the same time. For example, when a group of objects is conserved and their condition field needs to be updated with the same value. Modify All Records is accessible only when a tag or filter is active or when multiple records are selected in the list pane. The Queries lesson explains tags, filters, and selecting records in the list pane. Start by selecting the group of records you want to update. You can select them in the list pane by using Shift-click or Control-click to select them. Or you can use searches and filters to find the records you want. With the records selected from the Edit menu, choose Modify All Records. In this example, we'll follow the prompts to update records of all disciplines and change the condition to Complete Excellent. You can also modify all records on a group of records to append data to the end of the existing text in a field, such as Description. Precede your new data with a plus sign to append it to the end of existing data, or with two plus signs to append it on a new line. In this example, we'll append a short note on a new line. click the Next button to proceed with the Modify All. The Verification page will show exactly what changes will be made and the number of selected records. Click Finish to proceed. Complete the Track Changes fields as you normally do when saving a new record. When complete, note how all three records have the new condition. And the Description field has the new text appended to the end. You can also use Modify All to blank a text field by entering an exclamation point. Use Global Search and Replace to update a group of records by finding and replacing a string of data. You can use it for all fields, just for one field, or for a specific group of fields. It is useful for finding a word and replacing it with another. Global Search and Replace is accessible only when a tag or filter is active, or when multiple records are selected in the list pane. The Queries lesson explains tags, filters, and selecting records in the list pane. Start by selecting the group of records you want to update. In this example, we've noted a typo in the Cataloger field on some records. Eckert should be Eckhart. From the Edit menu, choose Global Search and Replace. Enter what you're searching for and what you want to change it to. Click Selected Fields to select the field you want. In this case, Cataloger. Check the box for Match Case if you want to find only matches that have the same case, upper or lower, that you're looking for. Check the box for Whole Word to match only whole words. Uncheck Whole Word to match a string of text even if it exists within a word. Click Find Next to find the first match and confirm that it is finding what you're looking for. In this case, it found the misspelled Eckert in the Cataloger field as intended. Click Replace to replace this one example. You can click Find Next and Replace in succession to confirm and replace each example. Click Replace Rest to replace the rest of the matches, or Replace All to find and replace them all. Both buttons do the same thing in this case. Complete the Track Changes fields as usual. Use Quick Entry to update groups of records in an editable grid view. Quick Entry is accessible only when a tag or filter is active, or when multiple records are selected in the list pane. Remember that the Queries lesson explains tags, filters, and selecting records in the list pane. Start by selecting the group of records you want to update. In this example, we'll use Quick Entry to complete several fields on these records: Catalog Folder, Condition Description, Eminent Figure, and Reproduction. From the Edit menu, choose Quick Entry, then Quick Entry Formats Management. Click the Create New button to create a new Quick Entry format. Enter a name for your format. Click the Columns link. From the list of fields on the left, select the fields you want to include in your Quick Entry format. Then click the Add Selected Items link. Your fields will be added to the list on the right. When complete, click the OK link. Then click Save and Close in the Quick Entry Formats Management window. From the Edit menu, choose Quick Entry, then Modify Records with Quick Entry. Select your quick entry format and click OK. The quick entry grid will open, showing your selected fields for the group of records you are working with. Press Tab to move from cell to cell in the grid, from left to right and top to bottom. Shift Tab moves backwards. You can scroll up and down to find the records you want to edit or work your way down the grid editing each row. In Quick Entry, the fields work the same as they do in the ICMS catalog screen. Press F12 to expand a memo field. Type in an authority table field to use the autofill, or press F5 to select a term, or Control F5 to view and edit the terms. In this example, we'll edit the condition description for each record and select the same eminent figure, reproduction, and catalog folder for each record. When complete, click Save and Close. Complete the Track Changes fields as usual. The records are updated with the changes you made. We are now at the end of this training. Remember to use the System Help and the ICMS User Manual. If you need technical support for ICMS, contact Rediscovery at the phone number or email shown on the Help menu under About Rediscovery. You can reach Rediscovery Technical Support at 434-975-3256 or send an email to support@rediscov.com.